Hello, dear friends, here we are. This is Moment of Harmony with Euripides Barsanulfo. We're able to be here on our second day, 21 days. And of course, as you can see, we are not in our studios. We are actually in New York for Spiritist purposes. And if you are near us, on Sunday, March 3rd, 4th, you have the opportunity of participating in the Mindfulness in Family in Mount Vernon. Just go to the Mount Vernon Spiritist Center website and get to know information. It's a whole day event for the family, which actually is needed. We need to talk about family. Talking about harmony, family is number one. We're not alone here either. Besides Carlos and Virginia, we have here with us our friends.
Hello, friends.
Yay, Carol and Mark, and everybody's like, soon, hearts and kisses. And they're gonna be there as well with the Mindfuls in the family, see? Look.
Yes.
Oh. Yay. Why not, right? So here we are, dear friends. We are here with the opportunity of calibrating ourselves. Do you think only instruments need calibration? No, we do too. You know, the body has a system to reset itself. Wouldn't God allow mechanisms through which we renew ourselves? We can recharge, we can begin anew. Yes, we do. And the renowned researcher, physician in America, Herbert Benson, he at Harvard University discovered more than 30 years ago that our physiology is prepared to reset itself. It's the relaxing response. The relaxation response is driven by the activation of the parasympathetic system. How do we activate it? Through breathing, conscious breathing, long and deep and slow. We're going to activate it. And once the parasympathetic is activated, our body gives itself an opportunity to recharge. We need it. More than ever, no wonder, all those who practice meditation, they feel differently. And this is the time in which to achieve harmony, we need to speak less, feel more, and go within ourselves. We don't need to speak everything we feel. We don't need to say everything we observe. We should be more mindful, more reflective, and by breathing in and out, we're not only nourishing ourselves in the physical body, but we're also creating a new opportunity for spirit and bodies to be in the present. There's no harmony if we're scattered, defragmented, our minds are elsewhere, our bodies are in another place. We need to be where the body is. Unless you are not incarnated, then you can be anywhere. But until then, we need to be where the body is. If you are in prison, we need to be in prison. But to give prison a new meaning, no longer aversive. I know it's easier said than done, but it's possible. Nelson Mandela did it, and many others. And we need to give a new meaning too, like Viktor Frankl in the Second World War, and the whole process of understanding the meaning of life in the most extreme scenario. Observing that when we give a new meaning to even noxious, toxic stimulus, we can overcome those impediments and react even physiologically, in a different way. All right? And why we're saying this? You're like, Vanessa, where's Professor Deepthroat? No, he's here. He is not away. He is here. And as for those who are coming here for the first time and are not acquainted with Professor Deepthroat Sanofo, he is considered the most complete spiritist medium that has existed on the earth, to our knowledge, said Chico Xavier. He certainly had that direct connection with Jesus, Mother Mary. He opened a new venue of feeling the scriptures. He got his mind straight to the point, helping people through his pharmacy, but also through school. A school that he created, Collège Allan Kardec, the first spiritist college or school in our planet. Why? Because without education, we don't move forward. We need to change the way we think. Today, we're reading a message that he wrote through Chico Xavier. This message was written in 1954. It was July 16th, 1964. Through Chico Xavier, he wrote this, and here we have the first opportunity to read it in English, thanks to the help of Carlos. Serenity and patience. In our spiritist task, we must not forget the imperative of tolerance. On many occasions, we are surprised of the shadows, by the torment of the shadows inducing us to fall in the hawthorn of unreasonable actions, which would not operate around us, but to the imbalance and the disturbance that is incumbent upon us to avoid. In similar moments, the blow of persecution and the outraged honor compel us to the seemingly just defense. However, our accommodation with silence and prayer is still indispensable in order to better discern the attitude that competes to us. In prayer, the Lord will reveal to us the imposition of serenity and patience, and the crystalline truth will teach us to see the despair where there is undue criticism, childishness where lie prevails, madness where sorrow and condemnation arise. In the heart, governed by the love of Jesus, there is no place for wounded dignity, because the dignity of the disciple of the gospel shines above all in the unconditional forgiveness of offenses and in unceasing service to the extension of the good. The accusing or ungrateful tongue is quite unfortunate in itself, and the hands that stone and tear bring with it enough misfortune. Therefore, let us refrain from judging, not because we lack knowledge or worth, but because we're servants of the cause of Christ, and it is only the Lord who oversees the redemptive work to which we have been called for. It is not worth precipitating actions and conclusions. It is either not enough to simple convenience. The constructive tolerance of the good that does not rest will be our indefatigable guardian in space and time, favoring in others as well as ourselves the clear vision of life. To exert it, to preserve the sublime work that was entrusted to us, taking advantage of the pain and obstacle as precious resources of our fraternal union next to the treasury of the evangelical experience. Thus, let us excuse the darkness in useless rush, valuing the light that the Master, the Divine Master, has granted us to the path of ascension. Let us remember that He Himself did not request on earth anything but the cross of the supreme sacrifice, from which He addressed the whole world the blessing of silence and humanity, of forgiveness and renunciation. Then, vigilant in our commitment to true fraternity, let us be attentive between the richness of the work and the grace of prayer in the sanctuaries of service, in the certainty that the field of our activities belongs to the Master and Lord, and in the certainty that acting under the norms of love with which we are depositaries, we shall have Him everywhere as infallible lawyer to pronounce for us in the opportune moment. Euripides Barsanufo. I know it's dense, intense, deep, but one thing we observe, Professor Euripides Barsanufo already understood that Christ is ahead of us. You know, sometimes we see pictures in nature of these flying birds in the V, you know, the V journey. And people are like, oh, so beautiful, example of leadership. But you know, the beauty of it all is that they accept that somebody's ahead. And our problem is that we're still rebellious on the earth, not accepting that we were given guide and model. Like children who are in their first years of life, discovering their independence, we're very much like them. We think we want to do everything by ourselves, and people say, I don't need to believe in God, I don't believe in Jesus, I don't believe in anything, I don't need it. Just like little kids who look at their parents and say, I can do it by myself, I can do it by myself. It's okay. And that's why God allows them to do everything by themselves. But then they observe it doesn't exist by themselves, because there is no moment in which we are not with God. There's no moment in which we're not being guided. There's no moment in which we're alone. So, now, in the Spiritist journey, we're being invited to consciously embrace this guidance in our first day. To calibrate ourselves in harmony, we are invited to ask if we see in Jesus our guide and model. Meaning, not He is the Savior, no, but He is the one that is kindly leading this journey, showing us the way. Do we accept already? But where? Not only in the Spiritist Center, anywhere in our daily lives, if we're in the street, driving, anywhere. If Jesus is leading the way, then why not surrender to His guidance and to His model? He modeled for us. And the more we instruct ourselves, especially in books such as Jesus in the Home and Good News, Boa Nova, we are going to receive certain guidance about how He did everything. And one of the things we're learning today about serenity and peace is about cultivation of silence. We live in a world that is quite I'm even without words. We don't want to label the world. The world is beautiful. The inhabitants of the world are quite unique, all of us. The other day I stopped by and just saying, giving an example. I was driving and we had to stop at a particular fast food chain restaurant, and I entered and I saw like the chaos, the type of food people are selling, whole families engaged. I was like, this is off, because this cannot be healthy. And how do people actually subject themselves to this? And I'm sure they don't do this only once in a while. They must be doing this every day or every week. And that lack of self-care, that lack of self-awareness, of love, people selling food as if they are selling